The preciseness of electronic injection was forced on manufacturers by legislation, by laws insisting on cleaner exhaust emissions. And it's legislation which may well force the next piece of electrical gadgetry. The headlamp washer, a screen jet operating simultaneously with wiper blades. You know yourself how a build-up of road filth can bake itself onto the headlamp glass and cut down the amount of light actually falling on the road. Well, if foreign laws, for instance in America, were to force the issue as they did with distributors, we might well see headlamp washers like this becoming a standard fitting on cars for our own domestic market. Not a bad thing, some people would say. But looking deeper into the crystal ball, we can see things like the headway control system from Lucas, which automatically applies the brakes, keeping vehicles on main roads and motorways a safe distance from each other, even in fog. And the German firm of Bosch are working on this little device. It's an electronic guidance and advice system called Autofahrerlenkungsinformation, or known to his friends as Ali. And it works just like this. There are roadside transmitters, estimated to cost for an installation at about £30,000 per mile, with wires like this set into the road surface. Now, all this is connected up with a central computer. The driver punches out on this the code for his destination. On this, we've got PRE3. We'll say that's from Brighton to Edinburgh using main roads and motorways, and then away you go. Each time he passes this roadside transmitter with this aerial, which is under his car, the information is thrown up on this display board, on the dashboard, and is updated all the time. It advises him of the safe speed, whether he should take the next left, right, or go straight on. I mean, for instance, this one here says there's a traffic jam up ahead, so he should turn left, and he shouldn't exceed 60 kilometers per hour. It also warns of slippery roads, fog, etc., etc. Now, this system will be undergoing tests in Germany, in the Frankfurt area. And obviously, there will have to be a nationwide system of roadside transmitters to effect complete coverage. If the cost of that is paid by the government, it remains to be seen what percentage of private motorists would want to spend £30 to £40 in buying the system for their cars. The makers reckon that only 10% of German motorists would be enough for the system to pay for itself in terms of saved time, saved fuel, reduced accidents, and reduced traffic congestion.